Welcome to nonstopneuron.com, where learning medical concepts is as easy as watching cartoons. In this video, we will talk about fluid exchange between intracellular and extracellular fluid. But before we do that, first let's quickly revise some basics about osmolarity and osmosis. In simple words, osmolarity is the collective concentration of all the solutes combined. If two solutions with different osmolarity are separated by a membrane that is permeable to water only, the water moves from low osmolarity to high osmolarity. This movement keeps happening until the osmolarity of both fluids becomes equal. This process is called osmosis. Now, in our body, we broadly have two fluid compartments. One is the extracellular fluid and the other is intracellular fluid. Both these fluids are at osmotic equilibrium. Normally, they both have an osmolarity of about 300 milliosmol per liter. So there is no net movement of water. Here the extracellular fluid is said to be isotonic with respect to the cell. Now just imagine that we remove the cell from the body and put it in a solution that has higher concentration of solutes. I hope you are able to perceive the concentration difference. The low density of solutes in the cell indicates a lower osmolarity and high density outside indicates higher osmolarity. Remember, these solutes are also impermeant. Such a solution with a higher concentration of impermeant solutes is called hypertonic solution. Now, because of the difference in osmolarity, the water moves out of the cell. So the cell shrinks. This happens until the osmolarity inside the cell becomes equal to that outside. The other option is a hypotonic solution, that is, the solution with a lower concentration of impermeant solutes. In such a solution, the water moves from outside to inside. So the cell swells. This also happens till the equilibrium is achieved. If the solution is too hypotonic, the cell might even burst also. So these are the effects of putting a cell in fluids with different tonicity. But this was only to make the basics clear. In real life, the cells don't move here and there just like that. Instead, what's much more common is an addition or removal of fluid from the extracellular compartment. Like in conditions like ingestion of water, infusion of intravenous fluid, etc., the fluid is added to the extracellular fluid. And in conditions like sweating and diarrhea, the fluid is removed from the extracellular fluid. So now let's study the effects of adding fluid to the extracellular fluid. To keep the discussion simple, I will show a single large block that represents all the cells in the body combined. The total intracellular fluid volume is about 28 liters. And on the other side, we have extracellular fluid. Normally its volume is about 14 liters. The height of the respective block represents the osmolarity. Normally, the osmolarity on both the sides is about 300 milliosmoles per liter. And one more thing, we will use solution of sodium and chloride because they are the most abundant solutes in the extracellular fluid. Such fluid is also called saline. We will try its different concentrations. First, the isotonic saline, means the one that has the same tonicity as body fluids. If we add such a fluid to the extracellular fluid, the osmolarity of extracellular fluid is not affected. So there is no net movement of water across the cell membranes. Thus the net result is an increase in extracellular fluid volume only. There is no change in intracellular fluid volume. Next is hypertonic saline, which is basically a solution with higher osmolarity than body fluids. Adding such fluid first increases the osmolarity of extracellular fluid. So now we have an osmotic gradient from intracellular to extracellular fluid. So the water moves out of the cells till the equilibrium is achieved. So there is a decrease in intracellular fluid volume. The extracellular fluid volume increases, obviously, but the thing to note here is that this increase includes both the fluid that we added from outside as well as the fluid that came out of the cells. Talking about osmolarity, there is a rise in osmolarity on both the sides. This means both the fluids now have a higher osmolarity than before. So these were the effects of adding hypertonic saline. Now let's see the effects of hypotonic saline. This one has lower osmolarity than body fluids and it decreases the osmolarity of extracellular fluid. So here the osmotic gradient is from outside to inside. So the water moves in this direction. The net result is an increase in intracellular fluid volume. Some of the added fluid stays outside. So there is an increase in extracellular fluid volume too. Talking about the osmolarity, there is a decrease in osmolarity on both the sides. So this was all about fluid exchange between extracellular and intracellular fluid. Now let's have a quick summary. In a hypertonic solution, the cell loses water and shrinks. In hypotonic solution, the water enters the cell, so the cell swells. And in an isotonic solution, there is no change in the cell volume. Adding any solution to extracellular fluid increases its volume. However, the effect on intracellular fluid volume and osmolarity depends on the tonicity of the added solution. If we add an isotonic solution, there is no change in intracellular fluid volume and osmolarity. Adding hypertonic solution causes water to move out of the cells. So the intracellular fluid volume decreases. And there is an increase in osmolarity all over the body. Adding hypotonic solution causes water to move into the cell. So there is an increase in intracellular fluid volume. And osmolarity decreases all over. So this was all about fluid movement. Now, for sticking with me until the end, here is a bonus point for you. When I studied this topic for the first time, back when I was in college, I wondered, okay, these are the effects of adding different solutions to extracellular fluid. But where are the effects of adding solutions to intracellular fluid? What I didn't realize was that my curiosity was baseless. The diagrams in the books and even in this video also show the intracellular fluid as a single compartment for the sake of simplicity. But in reality, it's made up of trillions of individual cells. So practically, there is no way to add or remove fluid directly from all the cells. Only the extracellular fluid is readily accessible. If you also missed this common sense, well, now you got the clarity. That's it for this video. If you have come this far, please don't go without commenting awesome in the comments. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.